So the second, so we've spoke about how definitions actually touch the design phase. Now let's start thinking about how definitions can actually touch your API documentation phase. So we know that API definition can actually keep all your internal stakeholders in sync, but actually from the definition, you can actually create documentation that allows your end consumers, the ones, the little people icon you see on the right, to actually hit the API and consume the API. So when we say documentation, right, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people on this call have heard of this. You know, there's like very popular open source documentations like the Swagger UI, right, which is very popular. It's like if you go to pet store, if you Google for pet store and API, you'll know what I mean. And there's like some great advantages when it comes to documentation, auto-generated documentation from the definition. One is from the definition itself, you can actually auto-generate beautiful interactive documentation. This means your technical writers aren't spending too much time, for example, working on making it great, working on updating the documentation. You actually can get this out of the box, auto-generated from the API definition. The documentation, the Swagger UI specifically, of course, because it's open source, can be hosted anywhere, and it's fully interactive, right? So you can actually interact with the documentation itself. You can understand what the API does without actually having to integrate that into your own code base to figure it out. So the Swagger documentation actually allows you to do that from the definition itself. Another example, which is not mentioned over here, is how documentation, the auto-generated documentation, can actually help in keeping your API consumer-friendly view updated as well. Because remember, APIs are bound to change. Your development, your code base will always keep changing. But before the Swagger ecosystem came about to generate documentation, your development teams had to be so in sync with the technical writing team. Every time the code base changed, the technical writing team would have to like figure out what are the big changes that have happened so that they can go in and update the documentation. However, now with say something like auto-generated documentation from the definition, instead of the development team going in and changing their entire application, instead of the development team communicating all these new changes every single time to the documentation team, they can always update the definition itself, which will in turn update the documentation. So you have a better feedback loop when actually generating documentation from the definition, when you actually design the definition first and only then go into documentation. And we have some popular examples, right? So this is, for example, the Swagger UI. The Swagger UI is actually the documentation for the Marvel API. It's used by IBM. So it's used by a lot of people. In fact, the Swagger UI and the Swagger editor, a combination of the open source tools, are downloaded once every 7 seconds. And that's a lot of download volume. And we're seeing this traction speak volumes about how different companies are also adopting a definition-driven approach as well. Music.